The problem we face on that front, the tribalism we see, is not a function of our failing to agree. It's a function of our failing to disagree in ways that are sustainable. American life is always going to be defined by disagreement. The problem is that because the institutions through which we have disagreed and accommodated each other and bargained and compromised have grown weaker, have grown less capable of performing those functions because they now just elevate the people in them as performers, we find it much more difficult to think of our politics as fundamentally about pursuing accommodation and compromise. And instead, we see our politics as about performative outrage, as about playing out the frustrations of the culture war. That's what we do in Congress. That's what we do in the media. That's what we do every time we think we're engaged in politics. And I think that is a failure to understand the underlying purposes of our political institutions. And in America in particular, and in this sense, I think America really is distinct, our politics is rooted in an understanding that compromise is the best we can do. Our national legislature, for example, is not a European parliament that says there's going to be a majority. It gets to do whatever it wants until the public says you're not the majority anymore. Instead, our Congress is designed in a way that forces and compels accommodation. I think that's a good thing, but it means that in a moment like this, it's especially important that our political institutions recover an understanding of their core purpose. And there are just a lot of cultural forces and incentives that are pushing in the other direction. Again, what to do about it? Because of the limitations of what I can do, the only thing I can do about it is write a book and try to persuade people that this is the nature of the problem, to see it in these terms, and therefore to do something about it in these terms. I do think that can make a difference. But there is clearly also a need for real institutional reform, and that's true across the range of our institutions. I don't think the problem to be solved is that people don't trust our institutions as much as that they're not trustworthy. And that means more than just seeing the problem anew. It means thinking about what could be done about it.
Well, the book's called A Time to Build. It's not called A Time to Tear Down. And you explicitly talk about why so many people, the people who are tearing down institutions, are making a mistake. They ought to be trying to change them, mold them, improve them. And we'll talk about that in a second. But I want to just come back to your point about parliamentary democracy versus the American system. It seems to me we're moving, again, slightly off the topic of the book, but it seems like we're moving toward that European system,
Yeah. The
use of executive orders by the president, which just keeps growing, which I find repellent, the extremes that are going to, I think, be increasingly frequent in terms of who's going to get the nomination. The idea that an avowed socialist could be the Democratic nominee, could win, is striking. It's unimaginable 5 years ago. And if Bernie Sanders wins, there was a leak a week ago of all the executive orders he's going to put in place in the first 3 days in office. And, I think the argument there for his side, it's the same argument that Trump made on his side, is, well, we have to, because the other side, when they get in, they're going to ruin everything. So we've got to save it now. And that lack of trust there, but in the system, the idea that there's a pendulum, the idea that there's counterbalances, the idea that there's compromise required to get stuff done, that seems to be disappearing in American political life, and it's deeply disturbing.
I think that's true. And one of the ways it's being lost is a loss of the premise that the people we disagree with are still going to be here tomorrow and the day after tomorrow.